convolutions become really nice if you compute their Fourier transform. How nice? That is what you will learn in this video. Suppose we have two functions u and v, such that the integral of u and v of the absolute value from minus infinity to infinity is both finite, so we can compute Fourier transforms later on. Then we know what the convolution is of u and v, u star v. So what do we need to do? You have u of xi, v of x minus xi, and you integrate from minus infinity to infinity. That's the convolution of u and v. But what happens if you compute the Fourier transform of such a convolution? So the Fourier transform of the convolution of u and v. Well, as it turns out, it will be the product of the Fourier transforms of u and v. So the Fourier transform of a convolution in Fourier space becomes nicely the product of their respective Fourier transforms. So why is that? Well, let's write down the definition. The Fourier transform of the convolution. So what do we need to do? Here we have the convolution, till here. Then we have to take the Fourier transform, which means we have to integrate with respect to x, and we have to add in factor e to the power minus I omega x. Now we can simplify this integral a bit, because we can take this e to the power minus I omega x inside, because this inside integral is with respect to xi. So the e to the power minus I omega x is a constant with respect to xi. And then we are in the second step. Now we can use Fubini's theorem, interchange the order of integration, like that. So instead of dxi dx, we get dx dxi. And the integration boundaries remain the same, of course. And we have the next integral. Then we can rewrite this e to the power minus I omega x a bit. We can write it as e to the power minus I omega xi times e to the power minus I omega x minus xi. You see those additional factors we put in of e to the power minus I omega xi and e to the power plus I omega xi are cancelling out. So we're basically adding a multiplicative factor of 1. So why do we do that? Now here we have factors which only have xi's, and we are integrating with respect to x in the first integral. So those factors which only depend on xi are constants with respect to the integral of x, so you can take them in front of the integration. So we can take them here and here. And then we are, there they are, then we are over here. And now you see why we did this. Here we only have the variable x minus xi and x minus xi and integrate with respect to x. So we can use a change of variables. X prime equals x minus xi. So dx prime equals dx. So that's over here. And here we get x primes and x primes. And now we recognize this. Here we only have an integral with x prime. Here we only have xi's. So you can take the xi inwards, and you get the expression over here. And see what we've got. Here we have the Fourier integral of the Fourier transform of v. Here we have the Fourier transform of u. So we obtained, after some manipulations, that the Fourier transform of the convolution is nicely the product of the respective Fourier transforms. And that's summarized in the conclusion over here. So, after taking a Fourier transform, a convolution, which is not so nice, becomes really nice because it becomes a product of two functions.